This is the story of Fort Mose, a famous fort in Florida. It's located 2 miles north of St. Augustine.
The Spady Museum in Delray Beach is full of African American history.
You can see that there is a fortified wall built around the community.
Charlene Jones is the educational program director. She says this woman, Vera Rolle Farrington, is responsible.
It's educators like her who are determined to educate people and to give them the information correctly and factually. It's people like her that keep us all from just, you know, wallowing in ignorance.
Farrington's dream to build a museum with a traveling exhibit on the ground floor and a display of local history upstairs didn't happen overnight. She came up with the idea several years ago when she became a member of the Delray Beach Historical Society Board and realized something was missing.
And in doing so, I discovered they had very little about African American people in the archives room over there. I didn't know why, but I thought, in fact, I knew that there were a lot of African American people in Delray who had contributed greatly to shaping or making Delray what it is today.
She had the concept, now she needed a place to showcase it, and that's when the city jumped in.
Then, at the same time, we found out that this house, the Spady House that was completed in 1926, was up for demolition. And the reason they wanted to demolish it is so that they could build a parking lot for the church across the street.
As you can see, that didn't happen, and today the house that educator Solomon Spady built in 1926 is spared.
He was more than just a principal. He was he taught people outside of the school system. He taught citizens how to save their money.
Once Farrington got her building, the memorabilia started to pour in.
The first African American who ran for public office in Delray. He lost by a few votes, I think 7 votes.
Here's a 1930s photo of Emma Reynolds. She's the first black female real estate agent in Delray Beach.
Everywhere you see a red arrow.
Her name.
Everywhere you see that, she was either buying that property or selling that property.
And that was in the 20s.
Mm-hmm.
Farrington has lived in Florida all her life. Her parents are from the Bahamas. She spent 37 years working in the public school system.
I'm glad I'm not in the school system today, because I'd be out there pulling up pants all the time, every day. You see the kids wearing the pants down? Looking at him?
I took a glance over my shoulder to make sure the photographer wasn't one of those guys.
I come over there and yank him up and put a big safety pin in them if I have to.
Farrington was an assistant principal at Boca Raton High School in charge of discipline, making her the perfect candidate for the museum job.
Were you one of those mean assistant principals?
Yep. I wouldn't say mean, but just strict, firm.
But she says the positive response she gets from students makes it all worth it, especially those who learn for the first time their ancestors helped shape the city they live in.
So that little boy's chest went out when he discovered that he was from a family who had a noted person in it.